Hi guys, I'm Ann Morrow, owner and creator at Pearson Bell at Home in Old Town Spring in Spring, Texas. As you hop on, tell me where you're from, and then tell me your favorite color. Mine happens to be pink. It's every color pink, any color pink, every color pink, even rose gold, all pinks are my favorite colors. So let me know what yours is in the comments below. And make sure you go to our page and give us one of those. And if you find our video inspiring, interesting, or the other, go ahead and send it out to your friends and all that good stuff. So we are, this is post-prep. So last week we went over cleaning one of these guys that we found in the attic. We also, so we cleaned it with white lightning from Dixie Belle. And then we also added the crust texture. So that's what you're seeing here is the crusty texture there from Paint Couture Texture Crust. So there you go right there. So you will also find all of these items on our website. And today we're gonna go ahead and coat this with milk paint. We're gonna go through the process of the Sweet Pickens milk paint. This one is Flower Sack. It is the whitest that they have. And we're gonna go ahead and get started how we do that. So I take, so we have these little measuring cups. I think they're probably like some kind of automotive measuring, any kind of measuring cup. So this has all of the ounces broken down here. So I'm gonna fill it up 1 ounce of paint. It's gonna come in a powder form. And it's gonna be 1 ounce of warm water. So we're gonna go ahead and mix that up real quick. So you can see how that goes. If you've ever tried milk paint, let me know. How'd it go? The piece behind me has been painted with milk paint as well. We got a nice chippy look out of it. So, let's see. That's kind of the idea with milk paint. It is one of those items that you are at the mercy of the paint on how it goes. So we've got pretty much 1 ounce in there. We're going to do equal parts water. And if you get too much water, no worries. Add a little bit more of the powder. Okay. And we have our handy whisk. And we're going to whisk this up. When you're mixing this, you want to mix it really, really well. And get all the chunks out of it. So you're going to be blending this for about 2 minutes. If you have one of those little small blenders, you could certainly, little handheld, you put your pot like for, I guess, frothing. You could do that. It's gonna make it frothy. This is gonna get a bit frothy here as well. And not to worry, because once you've got it nice and mixed, I like to go in my corners, by the way, with this, because it breaks out, gets that powder out of those corners. Really hard to kind of show you on here. But if you've ever made, smoothies, maybe the powder kind, you want to get all those corners and mix that powder all the way into this water mixture. So you get that all mixed up. Milk paint is powder form. It is the true milk paint is powder form, and you're going to mix that with water. Milk paint has milk caseins, the milk product, and will not last very long. So once you have it mixed up, you're gonna mix up what you're gonna use. So you don't wanna mix up, obviously, the whole bag, because unless you plan on using the whole bag, because it only lasts a little bit. So you can put it in the fridge to kind of help make it last maybe a day, usually a couple hours will extend its life with it. Now, if you want to not have such a chippy look, sometimes you can add the extra bond. I live on the edge, so I just apply the milk paint right on the surface and see what happens. So we're gonna mix this guy up. So it's gonna be kind of like a melted milkshake consistency. Let's see if we can get that. So, maybe the milkshake's been in your cars. It is Texas, so hot. So that's how you're gonna mix that up. So again, mix up for 2 minutes. So when you've got that mixed up, so So what I do, because you're going to have a little bit of froth on top and you don't want to have that frothiness, is I just take a little bit of Saran Wrap and for this piece. Now if you have a lid for yours, you can certainly put a lid on it. I don't have lids for these, so I just take some Saran Wrap, put it on the top, and then I just put my rubber band on that. And I'm going to let it sit for 20 minutes. I'm going to walk away from this, let it sit for 20 minutes. It also helps it thicken up. It is a learning curve on milk paint, I feel like that anyway. So let that sit, walk away. Go do something else, clean your piece while you're waiting for that to sit up a little bit. If you get to it and it's too thick, add a little bit of water, not a big deal. I have pre-mixed some, so we can go ahead and get started on painting. Might be a little thin here today, but we're gonna go ahead and start painting this guy. And I use our Dixie Belle Premium Chip Brush, just one of my favorite brushes that I have. And guys, if the comments are in your way, just swipe left or right to get those comments out of your way. All right, so we're gonna put a little paint here on our brush and just kind of go ahead and paint right on it. So this is where we have our texture. It's just gonna go right there. It's a little different if you paint it with milk paint or newer acrylics. It is very different. Again, you can control how thick it is with the amount of water and the amount of powder you put into your piece. So you're gonna paint it. This is a tough one to paint because we have all these grooves, all these crevices, all these spindly pieces. So I do use a couple of different brushes. And I'm not really particular. I do like to use the natural brushes. It's just easier for me for cleanup as well. We use our Little Lye soap to clean up. We do have that on our website. It is Lye soap, and we use it for all of our natural bristle brushes. Okay. And we have that texture here, so we're just going to jam that paint right in there. Stipple it on. And this is your first coat. Your first coat's like your crumb coat. If you've ever iced a cake, your first layer of icing is your crumb coat. Doesn't look very good. It's all right. It's just getting that paint on there, that initial coat of paint. So we're just going to paint all of our spots here. I'm going to get that all in there. Jam it in that crust texture that we had. And if we miss some spots, it's okay. We can go back and get that in a little bit. Once it dries, go back over it. Our weather is pretty warm, so you can pretty much, once this is dry, I go ahead and put my second coat on. I don't wait too long around here. So a couple of things you can do on your spindly things. I just kind of go around them like this. But I have found a nice little craft brush when I wanted to get in all those little spots in particular. So I found a little fan brush. I never used it for anything, but it worked perfect on getting in these weird circle spots. I mean, how many times are you gonna paint these kind of bubbles? You know? So it helps. I really like it on our second coat because then I can actually really get it in some certain spots that I'm looking for. But like right in here, it just gets it perfect there. And in there, I'm gonna go all the way around this guy. And if it drips a little, just grab that up. It's not gonna really make, to me, matter much at all because you are gonna sand that back a little bit. Okay. So I keep adding the paint on here. So like I said, it's very different. It's a natural paint. And there is no odor, just maybe a little bit. My mailman said that it smelled really good, so I don't know if he was actually smelling my lunch that day or the milk paint. It was pretty funny. So I think I'm immune to what paint smells like anymore. I don't really smell paint. Maybe because they're all no odor or low odor. This is water-based cleanup. I do like to use, like I said, the lye soap for our natural brushes. I use our scrubbies for synthetic and my hands. The scrubbies are awesome too. And you can use any, you know, you can use regular soap and water. I just kind of am particular about what I use for which brushes. I do have these brushes for a long time. Like this particular brush, we've had about a year and a half, and it's an expensive brush. It's a $7 brush. So, you know, we still take care of it really well. When you have these projects, you're going to kind of be going all over. So when you guys think about, when you come to my classes, y'all always like to pick these fun projects that are like this because you're like, oh, it's small. It won't take very long to paint. So spindles are going to be your harder item to paint. Not necessarily harder, it just takes you longer. You're going to be going around every little spindle. So when you're starting out, I always say just get like something simple, like a chest. It's kind of like paint the bathroom. Everybody always wants to paint the bathroom walls. They're like, oh, it's so easy. There's not a lot of rip, but there's a lot more weird walls and you're cutting in. So, you know, a big bedroom that's just square is easier. So trust me, when you find like a big square chest, that's the easiest one to practice on. I happen to not like easy ever, but once you get the hang of it, you'll enjoy it all. So, just gonna apply all of that paint on here. Now your first coat, some of it will crackle, most of it, like when I was doing the chest behind me, it really wasn't crackling, and I was like, well, I guess it's not gonna crackle on me, but by the time I got to my last coats, it started to crackle. That one actually crackled quite a bit and did a lot of chipping, which is exactly what I was hoping for. And of course, I'm new to milk paint, so I'm just having a lot of fun exploring the product and getting used to it. Like I said, it is a little bit different than milk paint. I mean, the chalk paint or the acrylics. So, but I do like it's lightweight. You can just pack it away in a little packet and mix it up with water. If you guys have any questions, just drop them down in the box. I'm not seeing any questions today, so I don't know if it's me or video there, but I will answer all of them when we get back, when we get off. I will answer all of the questions. All right. Okay. And like I said, get all your little nooks and crannies, wherever you have that texture, just kind of smush your brush in there and then smooth it out. Like I said, your first coat's not going to be perfect coverage. That's A-okay. Get it all. Just get your first coat on there. Get it nice and covered. Like I said, if you miss a spot, not a big deal. Just come back and fill it in. So it's very forgiving. We get into those little crevices here. Again, we're going to use our little flat fan brush. Again, I got it at like a little craft store, probably Michael's, little cheapy set of brushes. I never used this one. I was like, what am I going to ever use this fan brush for? I like it's nice and flat. It's in all those crevices there. Get it all coated. Like I said, I don't really pick an easy project. Maybe they don't pick me, I don't know. So, just get in there and put all that paint in there. Like I said, it's not going to look the prettiest. Your first coat. Most of the time, your first coat is kind of, wow, have you painted that? So, it's not until you get to your second coat or your finishing. It's not a big deal. It's pretty easy to sand. And honestly, it'll probably add a little character to your piece. And all around there. So we pretty much got it covered. And there you go. So again, like it's not totally perfect, it's okay. You'll come back. You'll get those spots you missed. When it's dry, you'll go ahead and do your second coat on it. A few pieces there. All right, so we're gonna set this aside for now. So we'll let that dry. Handy baby wipes around so I can get this nice and my hands nice and clean. They're easier than using the soap and water on the fly, so usually I'm going to do this. So I'm going to add these to here. I'm going to wash those out real quick. So if I don't have a sink back here, I'll just go ahead and add a little bit of water so my brushes don't dry out. Because your brush will dry out and get nice and hard and caked on with the milk paint. All right, so our next step is we're going to, this one's already nice and done, so I want you to see all the crackles and all of that there. Okay, all right, and like I said, guys, I'm not seeing your comments. Pretty sure it's something I've done, but that's okay. Ask away and I will answer them later. But I want to show you something really cool. So you see how we have this really cool crackle effect on that? That's the milk paint. That's the beauty of the milk paint. So what I'm going to do on this side, let's see. So we don't have a whole lot of crackling happening here. So let's see if my little trick will work. So I'm just going to spray, I'm going to get it wet again, spray a little bit of water, and then we're going to take a little bit of the heat. So bear with me while we have the heat gun going here. You're just going to concentrate some heat on this. That water kind of reactivates the paint. And it's going to help encourage more crackles. More chippiness. Kind of the whole idea of what we want. Apply some water, like I said, spritz it on, and a little bit of heat. I'll let that get nice and dry and it'll start doing some more magic for me. It'll start to crackle a little more deeply. So if you have a piece you're painting it with milk paint, now this won't work. I mean, well, I guess you can do some form of this with salt paint, but this really works well with the milk paint. And I painted this Sunday. And I did put a second-ish coat on it today. So, it's not like it's fresh painted. So, a little water. little bit of concentrated heat. So I do use the heat gun on this. Get it nice and hot. We've got a lot more, I hope you guys can see that, a lot more crackle. So right here, we created a lot more crackle, more definition of that than we had, let's say, over here. Okay, so again, just spritz on a little bit of water, add a little bit of the heat, and just concentrate it in that spot or those spots. If you want a little more deeper of a crackle, add a little bit more water. Like I just mixed it with a fine mister just to get it damp, and it will, and then add a little bit of heat to it, and it'll cause those cracks to happen. So now I want to really show off the crackle, and I want to show off all the crust. So what I'm going to do is take our dark beeswax. Okay, and so I'm going to take that, and I'm going to take one of my cheap chip brushes. All right, smells good. Smells a little lemony. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to jam this. So I want it in those cracks. So I'm going to just jam it in there. A little bit of crust texture over here, so we want it to really fill up in that area. We want it all in those crevices. That's where I want it. I want most of it in there. I don't really care how it goes on the top, because I'm going to take that mostly off. Okay, so we're going to keep adding. Where you have more texture, you're going to add a little bit more, so we have to get down on all those crevices. Use a cheap chip brush. This one I used last week, so I just wiped it off. I'll use it for this project and probably finish these up, and then I'll probably just throw this one away. It's like a $2 brush. I might keep it just for the dark wax. We'll see. So again, here you go. Hi, Stephanie. So that's the dark wax. I'm just applying it on there. Just kind of getting it in there, getting it in all those grooves, all those cracks. Just want to get it all in there. It's kind of messy. This is the messiest part of the project. Before I go too far, I'm going to show you something else. So we're going to take this, this is a clean, just a old rag, and we're going to wipe it back. So we're going to keep wiping it back. Here. So I like to check it and see, okay, it's going in my grooves. Okay. All right, so this is where we are on that, okay? It's a little messy right now, don't worry. Now, one thing you might want to do before you wax, if you are so inclined, if you want a little bit more to show, you can, now if I was doing the piece behind me, I do sand it, so I don't want it to be as rough, but this one is the way we want the style. I want it a little rough, but that's why we have the crust there. But you can always sand, and you're not going to break a sweat here, just a little bit. Just so you can see some of your original color coming through, if you're so inclined. You don't have to. Of course, now if I'm doing the project like I did behind me, I do want a smoother finish, so I will sand the whole piece. Now on a piece of furniture, I'm going to use a hand sander, so I'm going to save my hands. I learned that very quickly. I spent the day sanding that by hand, and then I went back the next day after a hand sander and finished that guy up. So I wanted that to be smooth. I didn't want any of the crusty texture or any of the chippiness. So I wanted that to be sanded away so it's nice and smooth, so it doesn't come off. These are decorative, so I like the chippy, really rough texture. That's the whole idea with these guys. I want it to be really rough. So again, the same idea on these little spindly things. You're gonna just get that dark wax any way you can. So you're gonna have to go all the way around, and you're really wanting to work that into those crackles. You want that to be seen when you have your finished product. You want that to be the star. Just kind of work it all in. And like I said, right now, looking pretty messy. All right. Put it all on there. And this is the dark wax, the dark beeswax. It is nice and pliable. There's no drying additive in this, so it does take a little bit longer to dry, but that gives you a little bit more work time with it, which is what I love about that. And I did find out you can actually use it on upholstery. If you paint your upholstery, you can use the beeswax to coat it. I'm sure we'll do an upholstery painting one day. I just have to find a couple of pieces to do, because it does take, upholstery needs to dry overnight once you've painted it before you can wax it. So that would be one of those classes or one of those lives. I have to have the magic next step ready for you guys. All right, so again, just like painting the piece, we're gonna go over the whole enchilada. Again, this is all dark wax. So I want it to fill my grooves, fill all those cracks and crevices. This up here real quick. So sometimes when you're painting with milk paint, you can have very little crackle. Like this one had some, or you can have a lot. Like I did force it out to have some with the dryer and the extra water, or like the piece behind me, it could do what I envisioned. It could just chip right out, just like I wanted it to. Sometimes when you're wanting it to, it doesn't, and that's okay. Just add some water and add a little heat. Make it do what you want. That's the beauty of milk paint, just kind of embrace what happens. I call a lot of this happy accidents. Because I usually let my furniture kind of help dictate where it's going to go. So I never really always have a plan of what I'm going to paint a piece until I start working on a piece. And we have had a few times where I thought I was going to paint it a certain color, and I might end up with a bright green color at the very end. So for me, I never know what color I'm going to paint a piece. I try to not go so traditionally white. So you'll sometimes see some brighter colors on our floor. And it is just paint, so if I get tired of looking at it, I could certainly paint it a different color. No big deal. That's the beauty of it. Paint it whatever color you want. If you guys are finding this to be informative, you want to let your friends know about it, please send this video out to your friends. We're, you can't use the S-H-A-R-E word. And give us some thumbs up. You know, Facebook can be finicky. Alright, so we're just going to do this side for now. And I'll finish her up later. So we're going to go over this part. So now we're going to wipe up all of this dark wax, leaving all of it in those crevices. I get really messy with the wax. It does get kind of all over my work surface, so do put a drop cloth down if you're working on a nice table at home, but if you're working in your paint studio or your crafting room, you're totally fine. I tend to make a big mess, so luckily I'm in my classroom. I do like the white and black too, Stephanie. All right, so now I've gotten all of this wiped down. So what I'm going to do now is, I feel like for me this is just a little bit dark. See, it's all in those crevices, all in those cracks. So for me this is just a little bit dark, so I do want to lighten it up a little bit. So to get this lighter, we're going to get some of this natural beeswax. Alright, so we're into the natural color. To get natural. And it's natural beeswax. That's the color right there. Nice and creamy. So I'm just going to take for this one, because I don't want it to jam into my crackles. I don't want it to take away from that. I just want to wipe off what's on the surface. So what I'll do is just take a lint-free t-shirt, cloth, whatever you got. Nothing in particular. Nothing fancy. Make this easy. Alright, so you don't need to buy a lot of fancy equipment. Alright, so we're going to have a little bit of the beeswax here on that, and we're just going to start wiping away that top surface. We want to leave behind the dark crackles in your crevices, but we want to wipe that off the top. Okay? Alright, see the difference there? Now you see the crackles, and now we've lightened that top up, so it's not quite as heavy with that dark wax. For me, I wanted to show a little bit more of the cracks, and I want it to be just a little bit lighter. Now you can certainly use, we have the oil wax. That's what's on the piece behind me. You apply it on nice and even. I applied it with a brush, and then you wipe it back, so you get a nice, even tone as well. On this, I just wanted to experiment with a different product, so I do like the wax. Like I said, it has a little bit more work time than most waxes do. We're going to get that nice cleaned off. So again, we just want the dark settled in our crevices and all those crackles. And I'll just kind of change over my rag and find a new clean spot. So I work in little spots or little sections at a time. And if you get too much off for some reason, go back and let that dry. Go back and add a little bit more of your dark wax later. And just do the same process. All right, keep going here. We'll add a little bit more. Okay. always find all of our products that we have in our videos. They're always on our website at pearsonbell.com. And that's Bell with two L's and an E at the end. That was our former dog, Bluebell. She was very naughty. But she did get a place in my heart, so we named my store. Yes, it does. It does change it quite a bit. So we went from a dirty old, what we thought were maroon corbels, to looks like dirty old white corbels. But these are nice and antiqued and aged. I love the way it comes out. Again, just kind of, it's a little bit longer process here because you're having to go through all the spindles. If you don't have all the spindles, pretty easy. Again, we just want it all to stick in those dark cracks in your piece. So we want it to look like we found, like it was this way for 100 years. It's been in a, of course, it's been in my attic for probably at least 30 years, I'm guessing. So I'm not sure how old these are, but they're really cool. They evidently came on the building we're in, and they happened to just find them in the attic and asked if I could do anything with them. So I was like, yeah, I would love them. So maybe check your attic, see what you got in there. Maybe you've got some like treasures that you don't even know are hanging up in your attic. I don't crawl in my attic. I'm terrified of them. I think things live in the attic, so I won't go in there unless I have to. And it's really hot, and I'm not one for heat, even though I've lived in Texas my whole life. I'm kind of fancy that way. I don't want to go outside in the heat. I don't want to go in the attic. It's too hot. Again, you can do the same effect on a piece of furniture. Easy peasy, just takes a little more time. Of course, you're not rushing through this. It is a step process. I love that down here. This is really good looking. Really good looking crackles down here. Again, we cleaned the piece. We used some texture crust from Paint Couture. And then we painted her up with, Sweet Pickens Milk Paint Flower Sack. Let her dry. And then we waxed her in dark beeswax. And then just to get some of that dark beeswax off, it's too dark on top. Each one of those crackles to show up, we then take a little bit of the clear, the natural beeswax, and just wipe it back. Super easy peasy. And if you like it darker, you could totally leave it darker. There is a black wax also. So you could make it really dark. And again, you could change it up by doing the oil wax that we have as well. A little different application than you would with the regular wax that we have here. Like I said, this is a soft wax. There are no drying agents in it, so it does take a little bit longer, but that gives you more work time with the wax. So you can get it just like you want it. Just work in small sections. This is what we did right now. We've only done one side of it. It's a little messy up there. We'll fix that. But once you're finished, this is our finished product. This is the one we originally started. So we got nice crackles on her now she's ready for display, hanger on the wall, use her for shelving, whatever you want to do with that. But again, you can take the same process, put it on a piece of furniture, go to town, put it on a jewelry box. You want to start small, but we're always here to help you, walk you through all your projects. And if you have any questions, just drop them below. We'll answer them. We'll make sure we answer those today for you. And again, remember to spread these videos out to all your friends, and go to our page and give us one of these. And we'll see you next Tuesday. In the meantime, happy painting.